Today I'm going to show you how to sync your Wrike tasks to a spreadsheet in Google Sheets with Unito. So the first thing I'll do is create a task in one of my projects. I'm calling it, this is a new task for my Google Sheets demo. I'll populate some of the fields here, and very shortly you'll watch as these fields appear in my spreadsheet. I'll just assign it to myself. And I'll jump over to the Unito interface very quickly and hit sync now. And don't worry, I'll show you how to do this momentarily. So that is my synced Wrike task with all of the fields that you see here. I forgot to add in a date. I'll just do that quickly. It's October 27th. That'll appear in a minute or two, but I just wanted to show you how the fields from Wrike will appear in a Google Sheet. This is the Unito interface. When you're building a flow, to create a flow, you click Create Flow from the dashboard here, connect your tools, and a flow just represents the connection between Wrike and Google Sheets that allows your data to sync bidirectionally. So you'll want to select the account for each tool, in this case Wrike and Google Sheets, and then the specific project or folder in Wrike and the specific Google Sheet. So I'm just going to click on the tool here and then my account. If you wanted to connect a new account, if you're doing this for the first time, this is what the OAuth sequence looks like. It's pretty quick and easy. You just have to follow the on-screen instructions and make sure you click the Select All button for Google in order to sync to and from Google Sheets. Otherwise, you won't be able to. And then you can select the account. Just going to choose the sheet. You can either copy-paste the URL of the sheet that you're working with, or if you know the name of the sheet or any of the tabs within it, you can type in those as well. Next, we'll set flow direction. This tells Unito where to create new work items automatically, so new Wrike tasks or sheets, rows. I'm choosing one way from Wrike to Google Sheets so that tasks create rows, but not the other way around. Next up, we have rules. So this is how we can choose which tasks to sync in case you don't want to sync all of the tasks in your project or folder. So you can set conditions, tasks assigned to a specific person or with a certain status. In this case, I've chosen any tasks that are active to do in progress. I'm just jumping ahead to my completed flow so you can see the field mappings. You just need to select these one by one, pairing up a field in your Wrike task with a field that you've created in Google Sheets. So this is where a table header or header row comes in handy. So make sure that the first row of your Google Sheet includes the names of your Wrike task fields. They don't have to be identical as long as you know the difference. And then Unito will be able to sync them together. And it's as simple as that. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out and ask our team. We'll be happy to help.